We encountered a lot of weather as we were crossing the Pacific Ocean from Los Angeles to French Polynesia. It took 21 days and 21 nights without touching land. Each day we would try to keep the boat moving as fast as possible and yet still keep the comfort level so that we could try to reach French Polynesia. Our goal was to do it in 18 days, but it ended up taking us a whole 21 days actually to get there. The Pacific Ocean is bigger than all land on Earth combined. The South Pacific Islands are scattered across thousands of miles of open water, stretching below the equator in the Southern Ocean. And here you see our route from Southern California to the Marquesas, about 3,000 miles south, and that's the Hawaiian Islands out there on the left side of the screen. We left San Francisco in the evening and headed to Los Angeles, where we did some last-minute provisioning. Then we set off and headed south across the U.S.-Mexico border. Within about 3 days, we're 450 miles south and about 200 miles off the coast of Mexico. The winds were quite westerly, which pushed us closer to the Mexican coast than we had expected, and we actually did a drive-by of Guadalupe Island, which is just a big rock sticking up out of the ocean about 4,000 feet high. It's really an amazing sight, and it took us almost a half a day just to pass it. These are albatross that joined us for several days during that area of the passage, and also these are one of our favorite birds, the booby, that has been with us the entire trip. This is a selection of scenes showing life aboard. Changing sails, fishing, watching the ocean, shortening sail at night, and fixing all the things that break. Our good friend Kurt Fredericks joined us for the passage. Kurt's a Baywatch lifeguard in Los Angeles, and his experience came in really handy.
Tuna splice.
In our case, one of the things that broke was our water maker. We were about 1,000 miles from land when it broke, and we didn't think we would have enough water to make it to the Marquesas in the South Pacific. So over the course of about 3 days, we tried everything, and we finally figured out how to make enough drinkable water to get there. Many people I talk to say, wow, 21 days to the South Pacific, and I say, yeah, and 21 nights. You know, one of the things about this kind of sailing is that it really is 24 hours a day. Somebody's always on watch. You're always trying to make sure nobody's going overboard, and so you're wearing safety harnesses. And I don't sleep that well on board, and so for me, it's a bit of an endurance test. And, you know, you're constantly moving. Manjula took a lot of pictures of skyscapes as we got near the region of the equator. Within a few hundred miles of the equator, the sky really changes as the wind blowing down from the northern hemisphere meets the wind blowing up from the southern hemisphere. And the air around this region for several hundred miles in either direction of the equator just goes straight up, creating some of the most fantastic cloudscapes on Earth. There was one scary thing that happened. Right near the equator, we were becalmed and we decided to go for a swim. Kurt got stung by a Portuguese man-of-war jellyfish, and we were afraid he was going to go into shock and, well, be in big trouble. So we used our satellite phone to call his partner Eric Nelson back in Los Angeles, and he got us set up putting an IV in Kurt. Within a few hours, he was back in action.
2, 1, yay!
We passed the equator at about 1 o'clock in the morning, and here we are taking a celebratory shot of rum. Manjula's pouring one for Poseidon, except it accidentally went in the dinghy. We encountered a lot of different weather on our passage. Most of it was pretty good, actually. We had a lot of sunny days, but we did have the occasional rain storm come through. On the 21st day at about 2 in the afternoon, we spotted a sort of a smudge on the horizon, and by later in the afternoon we were looking at our first sight of the Marquesas Islands in French Polynesia. And it was a really great feeling to be seeing land and knowing that by evening time we were going to be pulling into Hiva'oa in the Marquesas. Well, thanks very much for watching our film. You can follow our journey at www.sailblogs.com and search for the vessel name Endless Summer.